This video was heavily inspired by Lord Trent's tier list stuff, so if you enjoy this video, definitely go over to him, check him out and subscribe. Hello and welcome everyone, it is me, The Laval, also known as the Power to Duelist, and welcome back to another video. And I originally planned to put this up on April Fools, but I didn't want the opinions in this video to seem disingenuous. It's just that this is a tier list. So yeah, we have tiers from S to play limiter removal instead. As you saw in the intro, this was heavily inspired by Lord Trent. He's doing an entire series on his channel, and I basically wanted to do this after seeing his Happy video. So definitely check him out, and with all that out of the way, let's get into all of the Morphtronic cards and what I think about them. First up, we don't actually have a Morphtronic card in that sense, because first up we have Power Break. Power Break is a trap card that is specific to Power Tool Dragon, and you can only activate it while you control Power Tool, and it lets you essentially shuffle three equip spells from the field or the graveyard back into your deck. And burn the opponent for 500 for each shuffled back card. This has I was played once in the anime, written all over it, and for that I'll probably put it here into the C tier. It's not complete garbage, because recycling equip spells definitely is nice, but there's definitely cards coming up that are worse than this. Next up we have Morphtronic Lantron. Didn't see this guy too much on the channel, but I know a lot of people do like this guy, do like running this guy in more wear after focused builds, and I can definitely see the appeal since I have included him once or twice in a Morphtronic deck already. He definitely helps making wear after a way better card in the deck, grabbing cell phone and all that good stuff, and also helps into getting into your Hyper Librarium because it's a level 1 tuner. So for that alone, I think this might be a solid B tier contestant. A good card, but you definitely need to build around it, I think. Next up, we have a solid A tier contestant in Morphtronic Accelerator. By the way, I will not be sorting these. If something is A, it's A, and not because it's low A, it's better, better or worse than anything else in A tier. Back to Accelerator. It's an even zero card economy wise, lets you target a card your opponent controls, shuffle back a Morphtronic monster from your hand. Since this thing was errated but didn't get actual card text update outside of the database. So you shuffle back a Morphtronic monster, destroy a card on the field, and afterwards you draw one. It's good spot removal. You can definitely run it, especially since it is searchable off smartphone. Next up, we have another one-off anime card in Power Up Adapter. It is a trap card that you can treat as an equip spell, and it equips to a Morphtronic monster, and the equipped monster can't attack. And then you can target one other monster on the field, except the equipped monster, and gains attack equal to the equipped monster's attack. This is some niche applications in main deck OTK focused builds, but I would generally say this is as outdated and as anime heavy as Power Break. Next up we have Morph Transition. I honestly love this card, not only in design but also in execution. The sad part is it is a battle trap, and we live in the year 2021, so it is just that tad bit outdated to make it really good. But in concept, I really like Morph Transition. Negating an attack and changing the battle position of your Morphtronic monsters is really cool. And I would definitely like, if we get future support, a card that maybe works in this changing battle positions gimmick a bit more, because it's definitely something that I really like about the deck in concept. Next up we have the card for which I created the play limiter removal tier instead. Factory of 100 Machines. This is a quick play spell, just like limiter removal. It removes all Morphtronic monsters from your graveyard, banishes all Morphtronic monsters in your graveyard, And then you can target one face-up machine monster. It gains 200 attack for each banished card. So yeah, run limiter removal instead. Yeah, this doesn't destroy in the end phase and all that, but in general, limiter removal is a better card. Except if you're running Grandma Doom of Tronics, and at that point, I'm questioning your sanity. Although, that sounds kind of spicy. Now I gotta do a deck profile. Next up, we have Morphtronic Engine. This can only be equipped to a level 3 Morphtronic, and that monster has its attack doubled. And after two turns, this thing basically... blows itself up, and you take damage equal to the equipped monster's attack. This is early Morphtronic support, yeah, Crossroads of Chaos. And it shows, since it already sets up the equip gimmick that Morphtronics kind of have to them, since Morphtronics do have a lot of equip spells to them. But not many of them are really good. So this is definitely the first contestant for the D tier. I was already asked this once. Gadget Hauler is a... It is a card, but it's not a very good card, since it's a one tribute monster in an archetype that got Synchro access two sets later. And it's also a tribute monster that isn't really good, since it's 1300 base attack. And requires you to essentially discard at least two Morphtronics to make this thing semi-big, since it gains 800 attack for each Morphtronic monster you would discard for its attack effect. I wouldn't advise running Gadget Hauler, except if you're really going for that anime deck. Then we have Gadget Arms. Gadget Arms in concept is a cool card, since it is a monster that lets you add Morphtronic spells and traps from your graveyard back to your hand. There's a lot of good Morphtronic spells and traps. We have a Repair Unit, I think the Field Spell is semi-decent. Accelerator's also good. Sadly cannot add Junk Box, I know. But the problem is that this is a flip effect monster. If it weren't for the flip part, this probably would be at least a tier higher. Next up we have Morphtronic Borden. Solid B tier contender, just like Lantron. Shines in more specific builds, but is definitely a really good card. And something you can definitely consider even in the modern days for your Morphtronic builds. And also the one of the basically three main protagonists of the infamous Morphtronic main deck OTK with Radeon and Boxen. And I think for that alone, Borden deserves a spot a bit higher up on the list. Next up we have Gadget Driver, the last of the three gadget support cards Morphtronic got. It is essentially a hand trap you can discard from your hand and then switch around the battle positions of your Morphtronic monsters on field. Which is cool, I guess. You can definitely switch around some Morphtronics that have very, very good defense position effects. Maybe a staple into turn, maybe a staple into defense on the opponent's turn to block an attack. A Boomboxen does the same thing, essentially. Radeon to, you know, defense boost and stuff. But in general, this thing... Man, it got old. And it got old quickly. Next up, we have Morphtronic Slingen. This is going to be a weird one, since I haven't been on Slingen for a fair amount of time now. But Slingen is a really good card. Tributing a Morphtronic to pop one card on the field is a really good spot removal, to be honest. Nothing much to say here. It's a level 4, so it's definitely fine. Our level 4 lineup essentially is really solid. And Slingen is definitely... He's definitely up there. Then we have Morphtronic Mix-Up. This is a trap card that you can only activate while you control two or more Morphtronic monsters. You pick two cards your opponent controls, and your opponent picks one of them to be destroyed. This is a D tier. The only redeemable quality about this is that it's trap triggerable. And that basically also applies to Morph Transition, but I feel like Morph Transition is infinitely better. Morphtronic Videon. I would put this in B since just like Borden and Lantron, I feel like Videon shines in specific builds. Or basically, he has better counterparts in general. Videon is really good in equip focus builds since he can just be like, yep, I take three equip spells and just swing over a Chaos Max for game. But he can also just be a really good level 4 buddy that is also a machine, which is why I've been running Videon for a long time. But I've switched to Radeon since, because that you're missing a machine there doesn't really hurt it, but Videon is still a great card, and if I wasn't on Radeon, I would probably be running him. Talking about Radeon, Radeon also gets a solid B tier. Isn't quite A tier material, but he's still really solid, and you could definitely consider running him since he is an 1800 body if you summon him, and he's a 1900 wall if you set him. Which is a lot for this deck, if you consider that the biggest monster after that is Stapeln with 1400 attack and 1000 defense. So yeah, Radeon is cool. Also, essentially one of Borden's apprentices for the main deck OTK, so yeah, he helped with that. Next up we have Morphtronic Remoten, and this is a... I'm actually thinking about S tier here. Wait, I know what cards we have coming up. A tier it is. In my opinion, the second best machine dupe target this archetype has to offer. Machine duping's Remoten, making a link to, banishing Remoten, grabbing a Scopen, and then going into further plays from there. For example, a level 7 Synchro if you made a Platinum gadget, as I showcased in my profile earlier this week. So yeah, Remoten is a really good card, and you really do appreciate the guaranteed searches Remoten offers you. Cycling through your smartphones was never easier with Remoten. Stapeln is a solid B tier, I think. Stapeln isn't quite outdated. I think what really makes Stapeln good to me is the fact that it's a level 4 Earth. Since this gives the deck a really nice access into some Naturia Synchros. As I've mentioned multiple times, I want to keep my Earth counts high so I can consistently make things like Naturia Beast and Barkian if the format calls for it. So yeah, Stapeln is good, but he's just good. Next up we have Morphtronic's Scramble, a normal trap card that you can activate when you get attacked directly, and it lets you special summon a Morphtronic from your hand and negate the attack. I want to put this in C since it's in a similar situation as Morph Transition, but I feel like it is more specific than Morph Transition. On the other hand, Morph Transition requires you to have a Morphtronic on board, so before I argue on too long with myself, I'll probably just sit this in C. And then we have him, the first S tier Morphtronic card, Power Tool Dragon. This is our definitive boss monster. I feel like every Morphtronic player can agree on that, even though there are some religious defenders of Quasar Dragon. But I feel like Power Tool is probably the one you can just most consistently get into. He enables you the most plays, he can really carry his own in OTK focused builds with a couple of equips, and also a Synchro monster that searches from the deck is a really, really good card, grabbing an equip spell and then even being able to protect himself with that. I might be biased since this is my favorite card, but in general I feel like Power Tool Dragon is definitely S tier material. Morphtronic Bind. This is essentially an archetypal gravity bind, which on its own doesn't sound too bad, which is why I'm going to put this in C tier. Since it's just gotten old. Let's face it, Xyz era was the downfall of gravity bind. Nobody ran that card afterwards. And yeah, with Lynx we now have two summoning mechanics that don't possess levels, so Gravity Bind has just become worse over the years, but I feel like you still have some niche applications for a Gravity Bind effect. So yeah, there is that. And then we have the next member of the S tier, Morphtronic Cellphone himself. The main Machine Dupe target this deck wants to get to. You run one for one, some people run Wear After for this guy. Because he's just that gold. Good. Rolling a six-sided die, revealing that many cards from the top of your deck, and just summoning any level form of Tronic monster that you find under there, under those cards, is absolutely amazing. He enables so much swarming, so much board presence, and he's also just a great card. So yeah, Morphtronic Cellphone, definitely S tier material. Next up we have Livestream Dragon. I'm honestly going to put Livestream Dragon into B tier, since Livestream Dragon is good, but he is only good in very specific matchups. Yes, he's the evolved form of Power Tool Dragon. Yes, his effect is really good because he kinda works Power Tool Dragon's gimmick into his own effect, but he banishes equip spells instead to protect himself. He's got a really nice body, 2900 attack is solid, I think we can all agree on that. But yeah, the first effect that you can unsummon make your life points become 4000 is just something very niche that you might only need when you're basically kinda in that losing spot already. But honestly, the burn effect is really nice, and once we see maybe a more burn heavy deck, I can definitely see Livestream Dragon moving up in the tier list, because Livestream Dragon is a really cool card. Next up we have Morphtronic Scopen, and I feel like Scopen, oh that's another tough one. I feel like Scopen is A tier material. Scopen is a really good card, normal summon, grabs a level 4 from hand essentially to make a level 7 Synchro. In defense you can enable some level 8 plays or just kinda level modulate to fit your Synchro needs there. Which is why I'm definitely content with putting Scopen in the A tier, but I feel like Scopen is probably the one out of the A tier that has the most potential to go into S. Next up we have Morphtronic Clock. This lets you put a morph counter on it while in defense, an attack against 500 for each morph counter, but in defense you can essentially remove a morph counter from this card to burn your opponent for 1000. It's wave motion cannon, but it can also be destroyed by battle. I want to put this in D, since it's one of those out of place burn cards, but I once won a duel with this guy in World Championship 2011, so he definitely has some applications in slower formats. Junkbox! Junkbox is an S tier card, not only because it has Cellphone on it, F's in the chat for Morphtronic Bind, by the way. Special summoning, just any level 4 lower Morphtronic from the grave, is a great extender that enables you so much plays and also very good recursion on following turns. Next up we have Morphtronic Monitron. This is not a monster, by the way. This is a continuous trap. Don't get fooled by the artwork. We didn't get a security camera as a monster, although Konami. Yeah. D tier, because it's a continuous trap that lets you unsummon, swap your Morphtronic monster's attack positions. I feel like you can argue that this is just something that became too slow. You know, on normal summon, turning your Morphtronics into defense to get the better effects off. But the main problem is that's a continuous trap. If this was on the field spell, which we are also getting to, this would probably be way better. Because if this was just an extra line on the field spell, damn, the field spell would be much better. Morphtronic Vacuuming. I am a religious defender of this card, but I definitely see that this is kind of a meme. So I'm going to put it in B, because I think the removal effect is good. You know, targeting a monster gets sucked. Very nice. So, yeah. But I feel like Vacuuman is also very situational, since you can only target attack position monsters and you also have to summon him in defense, which means you basically have to grab him off a cell phone or you have to summon him off 1-for-1. Double tools C and D. Oh man. I feel like this is B tier material. It has good matchups, as I mentioned in... I think it was the profile or just a recent video. I feel like I know I mentioned it. Double Tools has some really good matchup with the negating the on-field effects of monsters when you attack. Shadows and FAs were some examples I brought up since some people in the pure format were playing those. And Double Tools definitely put in a lot of work against those decks. So yeah, it's a good card. You can definitely run it if you're going for a more power tool focused build. And yep, that's basically about it. Mofftronic smartphone, S tier. Easy, it is our newest piece of support and probably one of the best pieces of support the deck has ever seen. A special summonable level 1 tuner which just requires you to banish a archetypal monster from grave in general is great. And if that tuner also decides to be that nice to search you more cards out of your deck, even if it's RNG based, damn, that's a really good card. Makes Formula Synchron with cell phone and forms basically the backbone of the consistency form of Tronics, so this definitely is a solid S tier pick. Sorry. Then we have Mofftronic Rusty Engine. You can only equip a Mofftronic monster with this card, and if the equipped monster is destroyed, both players take damage equal to the equipped monster's base attack. This is a D tier card. It's worth Ring of Destruction, essentially. But it has the audacity to be searchable by Power Tool Dragon. So, I guess. Mofftronic Magnon. This is an anime card. If you've ever seen the anime, the legendary Magna Lock Leo performed against Yusei. You will probably remember this. But in general, nowadays, you run Staplin instead, since Draplin is a straight up better card. And yeah, that's about it for Magnon. And yeah, the next magnet is even worse. Mofftronic Magnon Bar is a D tier contender if I've ever seen it. While in attack, I feel like everyone who has seen the Archetype Archive from Rada probably knows about this card. This card has 7 conditions for 1 effect. Because it basically needs to be in attack position, you need to control 2 other face-up Mofftronics, then Magnon Bar gains the combined attack, and only Magnon Bar can attack that turn. Which is terrible, I know. And in defense, it essentially locks you out of attacks. So, yeah. It's a bad card. Please don't run Magnon Bar. Boomboxen. Oh, personally I'm biased here, since I think Boomboxen is a great card. I think Boomboxen is just a tad bit better than a staple and definitely belongs in the A tier. The double attacking, attack negating are some really cool effects on a level 4 Mofftronic. It is also a Earth. So yeah, I think Boomboxen definitely A tier. Mofftronic Force Field. This is a counter trap. that you can activate when a spell or trap card is activated that targets that would destroy a face-up Mofftronic monster. You negate that effect and afterwards you can search for any Mofftronic card or for any Mofftronic monster. I would have loved the second part of that effect on another card in the archetype, maybe the field spell, smile. But yeah, this is a really specific counter trap. You are most likely not gonna run this, but considering what kind of stuff we have in D tier, I'll probably just put this in C. It's situational as fuck and it's actually really bad. But yeah, it's not nearly as bad or anything. Oh, well, actually, D tier. Unlucky. Mofftronic Map. I've tried to make this card work multiple times. It is a field spell, as I've mentioned multiple times already. And when a monster changes its battle position, this card gains a morph counter. All morphtronic monsters on the field gain 300 attack for each morph counter on this card. And also when this card is destroyed, you can special summon one level 4 lore morphtronic from your grave. This is actually a nice array of effects, and the attack boost is rather decent. 300 attack for just one battle position change definitely isn't bad. But that is the keyword, battle position. So this goes into the C tier with all the other just one-off anime stuff that, or just with the old stuff. Next up we have Morphtronic Cord. This is an equip spell that you can equip to a Morphtronic, and when that monster changes its battle position, you can destroy one spell or trap card on the field. Yeah, limiter removal was Mystical Space Typhoon was once limited, did you know that? And yeah, every archetype kinda needed a way to work around that, I guess. Next up we have Morphtronic Repair Unit. This is... This is, I think, another solid S tier. Since it's a really good card, discard a Morphtronic, summon a Morphtronic back from grave. It's searchable of power to a dragon, which is why I think it just gets that edge that pushes it into S tier, because you have two ways of essentially searching for it, with your smartphone and power to a dragon. So it's definitely a really solid card and something that no Morphtronic build should be lacking. Yeah, then going into the last two of the monster lineup here, we have Morphtronic Cameron. While in attack, he floats into a level 4 Morphtronic from your hand. From your hand or grave. And in defense, Morphtronic monsters you control can't be targeted for effects. You were so close. Honestly, you were so close. If he would have summoned from the deck, I would have probably given him C tier, but... the way it is, it's a D for me. Morphtronic Datatron. I have both artworks here, the OCG and the international one. And I feel like both do kind of belong into D tier, fitting for Datatron. Since Datatron is one of those really weird burn cards that you had in the early waves of support for Morphtronics. Because once per turn he can inflict 600 to your opponent while in attack, and while in 600 by tributing a monster, and in defense he can once per turn burn your opponent for 300. You can't really FTK with him since it's way too specific to set up, and in general I wouldn't really recommend running Datatron. So, with all this out of the way, this is how the final tier list essentially looks. Let me know what you think, what you put, maybe some cards in a different tier than I put them. I just feel like this is a rather good way of putting these. And yeah, so let me know what you think down in the comments below. Let's maybe discuss about this. What Morphtronic cards do you think should be higher, should be lower? I can definitely see some people making a case for Scopeman S, as mentioned. I can definitely see why. I can also see people who want Lantron a tier higher, since those synchro slash combo builds are definitely really good, and Lantron is a good card in those if you combine it with Were-Af though. But in general, I feel like this kind of hits the nail on the head. And yeah, with that, I will just thank you guys very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. And I will see you again next time. But until then, goodbye.